The other day, my friend Srinivas, an Adobe After Effects champ, shared an animated video with me. It was a nice video with animated cartoons. I gave it a like. But then, right after that, he sent me this message. Can your PowerPoint do this? I could feel the sarcasm in his question. So, the PowerPoint fanatic inside me got deeply offended. I immediately replied with a big, yes, I'll show you how. Then I wondered, oh my god, what have I done? Is it actually possible to make that kind of animated video using nothing but PowerPoint? But then the challenge was already on, so I quickly scribbled a few lines of script and made this one. Meet George. He works in the sales department. Recently, he got his promotion as a sales manager. He reads a lot, works very hard from morning till late evening. He loves to meet clients and close deals, be it in cafes or in customers' premises. But there is one place George hates. It is the sight of a meeting room. He doesn't like to be there. It's because he hates to make presentations. Somehow, every time he goes on stage, all he sees is the faces of bored and sleeping audiences that dents his confidence.
Yeah, I made that entirely in PowerPoint and some free resources in about 10 minutes.
Let me show you how I did it, so you too can create these kind of videos and look like a genius in front of your colleagues. If you are a business owner, you can create your company's sales videos using this method and save loads of money.
I'm Ramgopal from presentationprocess.com. We help you confidently create engaging PowerPoint presentations so you achieve the growth you deserve in your professional life. Coming back to Srinivas's challenge, I figured that to create an animated video, I need three things. Some illustrations to visualize my script, some way of animating those illustrations, and finally a voiceover to tell my story. So I started with the first step.
I googled for illustrations. Soon I landed on this site called freepik.com, where I found all the illustrations I needed. The images were free to use with attribution, so I downloaded the ones that I wanted. Then when I opened the folders that I downloaded, I realized I had a problem.
The images were all in EPS format, but PowerPoint doesn't support that format. That meant that I can't use any of those images that I downloaded. What a bummer.
After a couple of minutes of frantic search, I stumbled upon this site called cloudconvert.com. Here, you can convert images of any format into any other format for free. So I uploaded my EPS images and downloaded them as SVG, inserted them onto PowerPoint, ungrouped them twice, and I had fully editable illustrations to work with.
What a relief. With that, I went to the second step of animating the illustrations. Right from the start, I knew that PowerPoint had all the animations I would ever need to complete the project. So this is how I went about animating the slides. On the first slide, I had to introduce George.
So I opened a new slide, chose a background color, wrote the text, then copied the relevant image, cropped it to size, used a simple fly-in animation for the image to enter, added bounce effect in effect options for the dramatic entrance, and the first slide is done.
On second slide, I had to talk about George.
This was the original image from the scene. I ungrouped it. First, I inserted George's image with phone to say that he worked in sales. To show that he got promoted to sales manager's position, I brought in the work table with fly-in animation from left with bounce. To say that he read books, I brought in the bookshelf from right. To show that George worked day and night, I selected the window panel and used change object color animation and animated it to black. I increased the duration to 3 seconds, so the change was slow and natural. I also used fade out animation to remove these glares on the window. For the third slide, I added another character to say that George loved to talk to clients and close deals. For the background scene, I went to Pixabay and picked this SVG image. To say that George met clients in cafes, I placed this free graphic from Pixabay. To show that he met clients in their premises, I exited the cafe graphic with flyout animation and brought in the work desk, window, and wall hanging with fly-in animation. It's the same routine for the next slide. To show that George hated the boardroom, I picked a meeting room image that was wide. I then added a simple motion path animation to pan the meeting room from left to right and used auto reverse. The next one is just fly-in animation for this piece.
As you can see, it is all about picking the right illustrations and bringing them onto the scene based on your script. The final step is to add voiceover to tell your story.
It's fairly easy. You read from the script for each slide and click for animation sequence. In just a moment, I'll share the link for a detailed tutorial on this. Once you finish the recording of voiceover, you export the presentation as MP4 video.
What a fun and easy way to create animated videos. Take that, Srinivas. As promised, for the third step of recording a voiceover, here is a link to a useful video on recording a slideshow with narration. It's a detailed step-by-step tutorial. You will definitely need it as a PowerPoint user. So click and watch the video right now.